I mean, 5,000 years ago, famous humanist and philosopher Erasmus Rotterdam wrote, "War is appreciated only by those who know." That's very true. I happen to live in war zones, war zones, I'm 30 years old, and I want to show you what I've seen, what I've experienced, what I've heard. Yet, first of all, to apologize. Some of the pictures I will show you are very harsh. But if you want to be honest, you have to show harsh pictures. War, what means victims of war? Means victims of shrapnel, bombs, victims of high velocity bullets, means victims of the first of the night. These are antipersonal mines, several models produced by different countries. Millions and millions of these inhuman weapons are spread around the globe. I took this photo 20 years ago in a dry river in Iraq. All these look like stones, but there is one which is in the red circle there. It is not a stone, it's a mine. Plastic. Water resistance that lasts for decades. When you step on that mine, this is what happens to you. And these are other types of mines called green parrots in Afghanistan. These mines are designed specifically not to kill, but to maim children. Because soldiers will never pick up soldiers, but children do. And what happens to children is that they lose one or both hands, and very often they remain blind. And that is the philosophy behind these weapons. To maim, mutilate children in the enemy country. This is not terrorism. I don't know what terrorism is. After many years of doing surgery for victims of war, I asked myself, who pay the price? Because I've not been operating Rambos. I've been operating most children, women, people who have never been carrying a weapon. So I did some statistics of 12,000 consecutive patients admitted to hospital in Kabul. 34% were children, 26% elderly. 17% male non-combatants, 16% women, and only 7% were combatants. So whoever speaks about war has to remember that 9 times out of 10 that bullet or that mine will hit a civilian, and 1 out of 3 is a child, a victim. This is the evolution of the victims of war, combatants versus civilians, from World War I till World War II and afterwards. In World War I, only 15% of the casualties were civilians, 35% were military. Today's conflict, over 90% of the victims are civilians, which means that the being a combatant is one of the safest jobs in today's conflict. After the Second World War,